Well, a few years ago, I was working for the New Republic, and Henry had spent the last 10 or 15 years of his career writing for the New Republic. And I spent a lot of time when I was an intern in the magazine's archives reading the back issues, and I was always struck by Henry's writing and how smart and how funny and how timely it was. And I'd been editing the New Republic online, and we were featuring writers who had written for the magazine in the past. And when we were looking for a writer to feature, Henry seemed like an obvious choice, but when I started trying to assemble the feature, it was clear there was just too much. Henry had written too much great stuff, and so it became a book.
And as you were putting the book together, what was it like for you having to choose between all this great material?
Excruciating. Impossible. There could be another volume with, I mean, there are 32 pieces in this one, and I could easily pick another 32 that could go in. He was a great writer, and you know, there are plenty more where this came from.
What were some of the things for the ones where you did decide, it's like, okay, this has to go in? What were some of the factors that...
Well, I think there are, Henry, there are some that were famous in their time, and they're so famous that it would be impossible not to include them. Henry wrote a long essay for The New Yorker about the establishment. Henry is credited by the OED being the locus classicus of the term the establishment, so that had to go in. Henry wrote this sort of notoriously critical essay about George Will, that had to go in. And then I was looking for essays that were timely, and they weren't hard to find. One of the things that made Henry such a great writer is that he was able to look beneath the little things, our manners, our customs, our politics, and to find the core issues that don't really change. They're the fights that we had 20 years ago, 40 years ago, we're having them now, we'll have them in 50 years. About America's role in the world, about what political journalists are supposed to do. So the ones that really popped out because they were so timely, those are the ones that I think were the easiest calls that needed to go in.